Got the messenger.
So now let's just see you real quick. One of the most basic reasons why a lot of people are against the Bible is because it condemns their lifestyle. You know what? You know why a lot of Egyptian, from polite on down the line? I hit him with this scripture recently, and he is stunned. Okay? They won't ever put me on that line when I'm shutting them down. But when you go to the book of Ezekiel, the 30th chapter, I hit him with this. I said, this is why a lot of you Egyptians, you Shaka Almost, whatever you call yourself. You know why you got a problem with the Bible? Because when you open the Bible, we're reading Ezekiel 30:6, where the Most High said, thus saith the Lord, they also that upfall Egypt shall fall. Not might, not maybe, shall fall. Now, no matter how many times we debate with these guys, why are they always still coming back? Because the Israelite in them know.
That's right.
This is where it belongs. Now, if they were so convinced in what they believe, why are they still clinging to this? Because they know the Most High said that all that uphold Egypt shall fall. And let's read on. And verse 7 says this here. And it shall be desolate in the midst of the countries. When you look at all these philosophies, the word philosophy comes from the Greek word philosophia, the discussion of wisdom. They're all vain. They have no makeup. Why that everybody still comes back to where? The Bible. Because they know the laws, the commandments are found where? In the Bible. And let me finish what he says here. At verse 8. And it shall know that I am Yahweh. When I have set fire in Egypt, when all our helpers shall be destroyed. And look throughout the entire planet Earth. Every city is on fire, including Egypt, including Cairo, even in the apathetic communities. They are damn near even on point. Here it is, when I hit him in the head with a heart, your man, Malachi, guess what? He in prison right now. Malachi, C. York. Okay, zero knowledge, zero understanding, and zero freedom. Okay, how come he was a clairvoyant? He can make a book saying, ask an Israelite 360 questions, but yet he can't figure out how he got in jail. Huh? Or how to get out of jail. Okay, but you still come back in. So when the brother said, I'm a lion back, not piggyback. He said early on pig, we should be saying pig. I'm a lion back and go to, and sum it up by this here. We can go to 2 Peter, the first chapter, at verse 19. I want someone to read it for me. If you don't mind, someone read it for me, please. 2 Peter 1:19. I'm holding it right now. Okay, somebody do me the honor of reading it for me. Loud and proud. I want y'all to know this here, right? 1:19. Even though we've had Israelites who have sold out.
Right.
Traitors.
Right.
Okay, to the FBI, the CIA, to the Rosicrucians. Like the Most High said, he's had a remnant that's still here. I'm still here. Danyaahla is still here. Brothers who came in here in the 1980s, 1990s, hold fast to what you have. Why read?
2 Peter 1:19. We have also a more sure word.
Because we have a sure word. The Bible's a sure word. So no matter what anybody may not want to believe when it comes to the Bible, they don't want to believe that we are the children of Israel, that Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shammah, Yahweh are the power and a powerful son. So what? Can we have what?
We have also a more sure word.
Come on.
A prophecy.
What's a prophecy? A prediction of what's going to happen, has happened, or is happening. Because no matter how much they try to dance, tap dance, or whatever else, they can't get around the fact that the prophecies of predictions are happening non-stop. Come on.
Whereunto ye do well.
That's why it's up to all of you who are practicing Israelites to hold fast, continue on, and keep it moving. Because you know why? It's up to us now. Once the Most High gives you this gift, it's yours to create. It's yours to cultivate as a man and as a woman. Come on.
Whereunto ye do well, that ye take heed.
Take heed. Heed means to be aware, to be vigilant. Don't underestimate this thing, man. At any given time, the Lord can shut this down. We're already seeing this country and the world over coming apart at the seams. No matter what, no one else is saying, we're still going to hold this to the death. Read on.
to a light that shineth in a dark place.
And you know what? The Bible still shines. No matter how much they want to put this anti-God, anti-Christ dragnet, satanic dragnet you see it all throughout the earth, bear in mind, it's deliberate. See, if we, why do you think, as Lord Tazaryach said earlier on, why do you think they're hitting us with this new fangled, made up heroin and all these different drugs? What do these drugs do? They open you up and bug you out of your mind and put you in a demonic state. Why do you think they're putting the foods that what? Destroy us? Because they know that we are the children of Israel. And if we get back on point, we take over. They understand that. They don't want to let this go. Why do you think they want to make people like everyone else go and walk away from the Bible? Because they're mad at the Most High for not choosing them. That's all this is about. Come on.
Until the day dawn. And the day star arise in your heart.
And the day star, as we know, is Christ, because Christ gave us what? A second chance at this. See, we don't even deserve this. Let's not even kid ourselves. But the Lord kept, he made a promise to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and there's some of us who are going to keep this, and that's why he still has in contention. Come on.
Knowing this first.
So know this first.
That no prophecy.
That none of the prophecies. All the predictions that happened. He said that he was going to take what? A remnant of us and bring us out. Why do you think we're all here? This is not by accident. It's by grand design. Come on.
Me está matando. Me está matando.
Is of any private interpretation.
So no matter what the light anybody else may say on the planet Earth, we are the children of Israel and our time is now. Okay? The Most High is systematically breaking this country down. And the more these guys talk, the more we rise. The more we uphold this, the more we show that what? We can't be what? Why is that? Drop that. Go to the book of Romans, the 11th chapter. It's already, you go to Romans 11th chapter, in the opening verse, you'll see where it's highlighted. It should be verse 4 or 5. And when I mentioned this, I mentioned this earlier on about the FBI, CIA, and Rosicrucians many years ago, I was one of many brothers who they stepped to and made an offer. Now think about this for a second. If this wasn't real, why were the Rosicrucians stepping to us, making an offer for me to turn my back on this if it's not real?
Right.
And think about it, why would you sell out what's already yours? Because a lot of people took that money. That's another topic, another time. But Romans the 11th chapter, brother man, and I want you to read right here what the Lord said. Because see, there are many who feel hopeless, they feel there is no hope, but read.
Romans 11 verse 4. But what saith the answer of Yahweh unto him?
What's the Most High answer to all those men of doubt? Who may, some of you in here might sometimes say, are we ever going to get out of here? Read.
I have reserved to myself 7,000 men.
I have reserved unto myself 7,000 men. Come on.
Who have not bowed the knee to the image of Baal.
And Baal, the money god or whatever god is out here, and that's all you in here. When I look and I see you all here, that means male and female, you have not bowed down to what? Being sold out. That's S-O-U-L-E-D. So hold fast to what you have. Maintain discipline, because you know what? It's going to get rougher out here. But put on the armor of the Heavenly Father, and you will survive. With that being said, I believe now it is time for the presentation. I say shalom. I thank you for your time.
Danyaahla, but before we do, we forgot to mention that Brother Zion Lexx has a book.
Come on.
And it's $15. It's called Kemet on Trial.
More fire.
So Brother Zion Lexx